So if you remember, Dave went away last time with 227 horsepower. We changed the inlet manifold and the exhaust system. We did see a drop in power by fitting the Mugen Twinloop last time. However, the car is much quieter, which is what he was looking for. This time, we're looking for some gains. We've got another exhaust system to fit. Dave's had his inlet airbox modified as well, so we shall see how this develops as the project continues. Dave has already upgraded his exhaust system and intake manifold. The next area for restrictions and possible potential gains are with the air filter. Modified by TGM, Dave's airbox now consists of no internal baffling, a free-flowing spoon air filter and a carbon fibre cold air ram intake. The first thing to do since Dave's arrived with this modified airbox is to put it straight on the dyno. As you can see from the dyno, we gained about 3 horsepower from this airbox mod, from 227, where Dave left last time, to now 230 horsepower. Reasons for this gain are quite simple. It has now got a spoon free flow air filter fitted. Internally within the airbox, all the noise reducing baffles have been removed, and also it has a cold air ram intake on the front. You can see the areas which power was improved, where the greater airflow was flowing through the air filter. After VTEC, throughout the whole entire band, we've had an increase in power right up to the rev limiter. Interestingly, as a side point, quite often if we run a car on the dyno with the bonnet open, with the air from the cooling fan, you will actually see a slight gain in power. In this case, we actually saw a drop. It shows that the cold air intake is working really well with the bonnet down, which is great. So back at the workshop again, this time we're going to fit the Fujitsu Blue exhaust after fitting the Mugen Twinloop, which we know gave us a loss of power last time. We've got both exhausts laid on the floor side by side. The immediate initial comparisons are that the Fujitsu Blue exhaust is free of flowing design, its pipework slightly larger and there's less bends. That all helps and adds to the fact that air will, and exhaust gases will flow for this exhaust hopefully better than the previous one. As you may remember, when we removed the Buddy Club exhaust and fitted the Mugen Twinloop, we actually lost about 14 horsepower initially. We managed to gain that back with the previous intake manifold modifications. The Mugen Twinloop system by design is rather strange. It doubles back on itself, obviously to help silence the exhaust noises, but in the same time, this is the worst thing you want to do if your exhaust airflow. You just want a nice, straight, smooth path. Any 90 or even indeed 180 degrees times 2 has got to be a bad thing. So I'm hoping by putting the Fujitsu Blue exhaust on that without the twin loop design of the Mugen one, we should gain perhaps 1 or 2% extra horsepower. Okay, so with the Fujitsu Blue exhaust now fitted on the car, off for a quick test drive and then onto the dyno. Yeah, we're pleased. We're back from the dyno and we can see we've now gained 5 horsepower from the exhaust system. Brings us to a total of 235. If you remember last time, we actually left the dyno previously, initially on phase 1 of this project at 227. So with the bolt-on components complete, we've got the power runs for the airbox and we've got the power runs for the exhaust. Now we're onto the fun part where we're going to map the ECU and optimise everything on the car. Changing anything that affects the airflow through a car will affect the optimal point at which these happen. So now we can change these and bring everything back to where it should be and we should see a power gain. The glass, but see it grow, like a ride, oh, that is a We're back off the dyno, the mapping's complete, and the power gains speak for themselves. Bear in mind this is 2-litre 16 valve engine, we're now making 243 horsepower. Pretty amazing really. No internal mods whatsoever, everything's been bolt on. You can clearly see how the mapping's helped by optimising the fueling and ignition. As a result, we've got a bigger power gain from the mapping part of this project alone than we did by any of the bolt on components we fitted earlier. It makes you wonder just how far you can push these engines. I'd like to think that this demonstrates the fact of how important mapping is. It's all very well bolting parts onto your car, and yeah, we've proven you can get gains, but we've also proven you can get bigger gains if you have them all set up properly as well. There's fairly limited room for improvement with bolt-ons, so I think we shall leave the car to him and see what he brings back next time.